Half a day. My name is M.A.T. Jaren, and I'm from the island of Guam. And in recognition of Asian American Pacific Islander Month, I would like to talk about Brigadier General Vicente Blas. General Blas is an amazing example of someone who came across extreme hardship when he was younger, but did not let that hold him back. During World War II, a 13-year-old General Blas was forced into labor. 3 years later, upon the liberation of Guam, General Blas wanted to join the people who liberated Guam and eventually set sail to attend the University of Notre Dame and join the U.S. Marine Corps Reserve at the onset of the Korean War. After graduating, he was commissioned as a second lieutenant, later doing various tours and even being part of the same regiment that liberated Guam. In 1977, he rose to the rank of Brigadier General, becoming the first flag officer from the island of Guam. After retiring from the Marine Corps, he served the people of Guam as a congressman. General Blas later passed away in 2014. General Blas truly embodied the values and spirit of Guam, the Chamorro people, and the U.S. Marine Corps.
Susan Ann Cuddy was born in 1915 in Los Angeles, California, and is the eldest daughter of Dyson Chun Hu and Helen Ann. Her parents were the first Korean married couple to immigrate to the United States in 1902. Following the Japanese bombing of Pearl Harbor, she felt the need to join the Navy as a way to help free Korea from the harsh Japanese colonial era rule. She attempted to attend the Officer Candidate School, but was denied. Eager to join the Navy to fight the Japanese, she became a member of WAVES, Woman Accepted for Volunteer Emergency Service, in 1942, and to become the first Asian American woman in the Navy. She worked her way up into the Navy and became a Navy Link instructor in 1943. She was responsible for teaching aviators how to maneuver in a simulator cockpit. And later, when she was accepted into OCS, she became the first U.S. woman aerial gunnery officer. Susan Ann Cuddy eventually advanced to lieutenant until she left the Navy in 1946 and went on to work for the U.S. Navy Intelligence and the Library of Congress. During her time working at the NSA, the National Security Agency in Washington, D.C., she was in charge of the think tank of over 300 agents working in the Russian sector during the Cold War. She received a fellowship from the National Security Agency to study at the University of Southern California in 1956. Susan worked on many top secret projects for the Department of Defense and other agencies during her service with the United States government until 1959. In her elder years, she remained active, speaking at Navy functions and Korean American community events, even campaigning with President candidate Barack Obama. A breast cancer survivor, she helped raise money for the cause. She was honored with many accolades from government bodies and nonprofits. The Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors designated a Susan on Cuddy Day. Supervisor Mark Riley Thomas, who introduced the declaration, was especially a devoted fan. He said, "These were all firsts as an Asian American woman in a man's world. Anti-Asian sentiment was blazingly prevalent, but that did not deter Susan. She just knew what her mission was."
Hello, my name is MC2 Frazier, and in recognition of Asian American Pacific Islander Month, I would like to tell you a little bit about Rear Admiral Ming Chang. A graduate of William & Mary and the Naval Postgraduate School, Rear Admiral Ming Chang joined the Navy in 1958. He served as the commanding officer of the USS Rathburn Reeves, the Chief of Staff for Carrier Group 3, Chief of Staff for Commander 3rd Fleet, and Commander Cruiser Destroyer Group 2. As a Rear Admiral, he served as Deputy Commander, Weapons and Combat Systems, Naval Sea Systems Command. In 1987, he became the Department of the Navy Inspector General. Rear Admiral Ming Chang served in the U.S. Navy for 34 years, becoming the first naturalized Asian American naval officer to reach flag rank in the United States military.
Hello, my name is CS2 Ivy, and I was born and raised in the Philippines. Today, I will be sharing with you my favorite Filipino afternoon snack, deep-fried battered quail eggs, or as we call it in my country, kwek kwek. Now let's get started. First, we need to make the dipping sauce. And for this, you will need 1/2 cup of vinegar, 1/8 cup of water, 1 teaspoon of sugar, salt and pepper to taste, 1 teaspoon of crushed garlic, 1 tablespoon of chopped shallots or onions, and about 1/4 cup of diced cucumber. Now you just have to mix all the ingredients together. And set aside. For the kwek kwek, you're gonna need 10 quail eggs, cooked and peeled, 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, 1/8 cup of cornstarch, 1/2 cup of water, salt and pepper to taste, 1/4 teaspoon baking powder, 1 teaspoon annatto powder, and extra cornstarch for dredging. You're also gonna need cooking oil. For the batter, combine the flour, cornstarch, baking powder, annatto powder, salt and pepper. Whisk to combine and add your water. Keep whisking until it forms a slurry. Now we're ready to cook. So you need to heat your oil. When your oil is about to be ready, you're gonna need to coat your quail eggs in cornstarch. Shake off the excess cornstarch and drop it in the batter. Coat your quail eggs in the batter. And we're ready to fry. We're gonna fry this for about a minute. And repeat the same for the remaining quail eggs.
Hello, this is Kazu. Happy Asian Pacific Islanders Heritage Month. I'd like to share with you how to make the Japanese fried dish. It's called tempura. Okay. Main ingredients are assorted organic vegetables. Okay, so carrot, sweet potato, and eggplant, codfish, okay, diced, pesticide-free flour, and organic olive oil or similar one of your choice, and then purified water. All right, so let's make some batter. So what all you need is 1-to-1 ratio, so 1 part flour and 1 part water. Okay, so you just put the water, then. Excuse me. Then you just mix it. You don't need to mix it thoroughly because if you mix it too much, you might end up getting more gluten. All right. So it's ready to cook. Awesome sauce. All right. So I just pour the organic olive oil. All right. So I'm gonna set the temperature at 180 centigrade, which is equivalent to 375 F. All right, so number one. Some carrots, sweet potato, all right. close the lid. The reason why I put the lid because it cooks faster, because this particular one, it acts like the Dutch oven, so you want to get cooked faster. But when you lift the lid, do slide this way, because you don't want the moist that you see here going back to the oil. Yes, it's going to be the catastrophe. Yes, now, so ready to flip. All right, see how easy that is. Right. Yeah. Don't worry about sticking, because at the end you can divide it. Right. Yeah. Okay, it's ready. So when you do this, make sure you get rid of the oil, excess oil, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's try the fish tempura. Fish. Here. It's easy does it. Easy does it. Yeah, it smelled so good already. Amazing. Yes. Wow, you see that? It's wonderful, isn't it? Let's see. Maybe I can turn down to 170. Take only maybe 30 seconds. Here, you see that? It's so easy. Yes. Tempura is a traditional Japanese dish. Yes. Beautiful. Okay, it's ready. The assorted tempura, okay, so made from organic vegetables and codfish. All right, ladies and gentlemen, happy Asian Pacific Islander Heritage Month. God bless you all. Thank you for your service. Thank you. Arigatou gozaimasu.
Hi, Yokosuka. It's good to be here this evening with the CFAY Multicultural Committee to celebrate Asian American and Pacific Islander Heritage Month. We really enjoy the food here in Japan, and so we thought we'd share with you a basic comfort food recipe that we enjoy based upon Japanese ingredients: udon noodles with seared catfish. For this recipe, you'll need the following ingredients: udon noodles, catfish fillets, celery, carrots, white button mushrooms, scallions, fresh ginger, yakiniku sauce, and furikake seasoning. To prepare this recipe, first you cook your vegetables. Start with your carrots and mushrooms, and then add the celery, ginger, and white bottoms of the scallions. Once your vegetables are done, add the udon noodles to the pan. Create a broth with the yakiniku sauce and water. In a separate pan, sear your catfish fillets. Once done, you can top your noodles and vegetables in a bowl with the catfish. Garnish with your furikake seasoning and the green tops of scallions.
いただきます。